you are with The Big Story here. I'm Seher Zama. This is our top focus today with respect to safety of air passengers. The latest case here that has come in, a mid-air scare at a Guwahati-Kolkata GoAir flight. Aviation regulator, which is the DGCA, the Directorate General of Civil Aviation, has now ordered an inspection of all the Pratt & Whitney engines that have been used for over 3,000 hours, specifically of the GoAir's A320neo planes. A senior DGCA official now says action will be taken in the matter post the inspection of all of these aircrafts. And this is because two instances of technical snags that have been reported faced by this particular airlines in 2 days. On Sunday itself, there was a GoAir aircraft that had to return to Mumbai on an emergency soon after taking off for Chandigarh because of engine trouble. And on Monday, this is the second case, a GoAir flight operating from Guwahati to Kolkata had to land back in Guwahati with barely 10 minutes of flight time because of a snag. But this has been a running conversation as far as the Pratt & Whitney engines are concerned. In October this year, the DGCA had also ordered Indigo to replace 16 of those Pratt & Whitney engines in their aircrafts. They had been used for over 3,000 hours. As engines of Indigo's aircrafts also face similar issues, similar snag, we are now seeing this happening in GoAir as well. Let's throw this debate open here to our guest, Mr. Sudhakar Reddy, who is the founder and the national president of the Air Passengers Association of India. We also have with us Mr. Harshvardhan, aviation expert. Appreciate you being with us, gentlemen. Stay on with us in just a bit, coming to you. First, going across to our correspondent, Neha, who is getting us further details in these two latest cases that have been reported. Neha, this is keeping in mind in multiple extensions of notices that have come in for these two airlines and these concerned aircrafts, even by the DGCA, there have been extensions to that deadline, some of the engines that have been changed, and yet there are some that continue to be used, risking the lives of air passengers.
That's right, Seher. And the main fact here remains that both the airlines have not been able to confirm and give an appropriate figure as to how many of these engines which have been using Pratt & Whitney make have been able to replace these engines and get the modified ones from Pratt & Whitney. And with the recent incidents being reported of GoAir, is definitely scary for the passengers who are flying these flights now, because it is very important that an updated figure either from the regulatory body and from the airlines is given to the passengers. That kind of information is shared about how many engines have been replaced and what information has been given to passengers. In these two flight cases specifically, Seher, what had happened is that in one case, especially in the Guwahati and Kolkata flight, the passengers there had reported about hearing a loud bang sound when they were airborne, when they were inside the flight. In fact, one of them also said that they saw the fire at the tail tip of the engine of the flight when it was airborne. So such details were given by the passengers to DGCA, post which the investigation was taken up. The DGCA has now asked that all the engines of GoAir, which have completed more than 3,000 hours of flight, will be checked.
All right. Let's get this into our panelists. First to you, Mr. Sudhakar Reddy. This is as far as the rights of air passengers are concerned, the bare minimum concern that needs to be taken into account. Safety. We'll be paying for our tickets and we're hoping that safety is taken into account. These are a couple of snags that have been reported. This has been brought to the public domain ever since October, when notices were issued out by the DGCA. Since October, several months down the line, and we're still facing that roadblock and on an absolute change of engines of the Pratt & Whitney, which have flown beyond 3,000 hours.
Yeah. You want me to? Hello? Hello?
Yes, Mr. Reddy, please go ahead.
Yeah, yeah. See, one thing we must remember is this is an issue that has been ongoing for more than 3 years now. And it is unfortunate that only Indian passengers have become guinea pigs Whereas in the rest of the world, the regulators have ordered them to be grounded and they have asked them to replace the engines or modify the engines. Now, whereas in our country, we are talking about whether the engine has flown 3,000 hours. We must also remember how many passengers have suffered and what is the time, you know, lost. Why does a passenger fly by an airline? He has work or holiday or some other commitment. And if he is, you know, if it takes more than 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours, the combined loss of number of hours,
right,
has DGCA ever calculated? We want to know from them whether they are aware of the number of man hours that have been lost in this process over the last 3 years. It will run into lakhs of hours, not 3,000 hours. And the DGCA trying to find some kind of a, you know, excuse coming up with 3,000 hours and all this. I mean, I'm sorry to say that this cannot be the attitude and this can't be allowed to go on.
Mr. Harshvardhan, in your view, do you think that the DGCA in this needs to be taken to task here? Because we've seen earlier as well that despite the problem having been identified, airlines were given 2 months' notice in October, which was further extended to the next date in November and still been extended here. Why is this lackadaisical attitude as far as lives of people is concerned? Why are we not seeing zero tolerance from the DGCA on these cases?
Well, I think it's a very serious issue and it's a safety related issue. There is no doubt about the fact that this is now a fleet snag which has been persisting ever since launch of this engine on this aircraft. The engine does provide fuel efficiency more than its counterpart, but that is no reason that such an engine should allow to be continued to fly till the snags are resolved. And this is not a recent phenomena that you've just come across. This has been going on for the last 3 years, as Mr. Reddy has said. And this being a fleet issue, having noticed it for so long, if the patentability has not been able to fix it so far, I think we need to go back to the drawing board. Mm-hmm. And DGCA ought to take more serious view on it, because I have noticed that Indian DGCA is usually the last to react. And they usually wait for some catastrophe to take place before some strict measures to be taken. And, you know, you have seen in last 1.5 years ago when Boeing 737 MAX issue was handled, everybody else in the world had grounded the fleet only then the Indian GCC reacted.
Yes.
So basically, we cannot depend on the FAA or EASA certification. India must realize that we are now a major aircraft market. We are major aircraft users, and the A320neo has a sizable fleet in India.
What is stopping? What are the concerns, the aviation industry concerns or market concerns, that is stopping the DGCA from taking a far more strict action?
Well, you see, I think it's basically their lackadaisical attitude to the safety. To be very honest, they do not have the technical competence to actually assess the performance of the engine. The best they have is only to analyze the data and go through it. Unlike the test facilities, which ought to be there now in India with such a large usage of aircraft, we do not have the technical competence. Our R&D division is very weak as far as the basic aircraft certification or analysis is concerned. So we cannot carry out primary analysis of defects. We can only depend on data which is supplied to them. So that to some extent acts as an impediment in taking an independent view. But even then, seeing such a large fleet snags, DGCA should ground the fleet until a full satisfactory solution is found. You cannot be looking at the airline's comfort, that, you know, it will hurt the passengers, it will hurt their right. flying, or it will have impact on the international relations. Safety and the people's life cannot be taken lightly, and it is about time DGC act in its own.
Let's in fact get in a word. Yes, Mr. Harshvardhan, please stay on with us. We also have Mr. Shiva Raman, who's the former DGCA chief with us over the phone line. Thank you for being with us, Mr. Shiva Raman. In your view, are we looking at a scenario wherein which the DGCA has been dragging its feet on this, as far as taking a far more stern action on airlines which are still using their Pratt & Whitney engines? We're not looking at a zero tolerance here from the DGCA, and why is that?
So at present, if you see the aviation sector as well as the communication sector, there is a beggar thy neighbor policy being pursued and fierce competition leading to reduction in rates, passenger fares or rates there in the case of communication sector, to a level at which right. all these organizations are suffering heavy losses. The DGCA has been able to do nothing about it. So therefore, he has to intervene, both as far as the passenger fares are concerned, which are economical in the sense the airlines are able to assure passenger safety. Passenger is also to see at the trade-off between passenger fares and ensuring safety. Engine manufacturers are trying to manufacture engines which they claim to be fuel efficient, but probably not as safe as is required to be. And the manufacturers of aircraft, they are plunging right. in for these new engines, thinking that they will save a lot on fuel. Fuel is only 40% of
right.
the total
so, operating cost. Mr. Shiva Raman, we're aware of what's causing this problem here, but we want to know, within the wherewithal of the DGCA, what they should be doing at this time, apart from just sending in notices and extending the dates of those notices to get these engines changed. What is it that one remarkable decision that the DGCA should be taking today, wherein which it shows that passengers' safety of their lives is priority for the DGCA?
Should not allow any aircraft, new aircraft, to have engines which has not been proved safe under all circumstances. If those engines have been mounted on aircraft, if I were the DGCA, I will ask the airlines to dismount them and put in only those engines which have had a history of assured safety in the flying of the aircraft.
All right, so that is one step here that the DGCA should be taking right now. Mr. Sudhakar Reddy, are you in approval of that? That altogether not allowing these aircraft to fly, that would mean that available feed would be reduced drastically. But do you think that is a desirable step?
No, I don't think what Mr. Sivaraman said is true. Because all the new aircrafts which have been coming in with the modified PW engine. The problem is lying with those which have been imported 6 months to 8 months earlier. And those are the aircrafts which are having problem because they have not modified these engines. And it has been shown that there are totally about 52 aircrafts as of October, both with Indigo and GoAir, which had, unmodified engines. You see, by asking them to ground these 52 aircrafts, nothing is going to happen. I can assure you, no passenger will suffer, no economy will suffer, nothing will happen. They should do it to prove that they mean business. DGCA cannot give lip service, and they have to be more concerned with the safety of passengers than the coffers of the airlines. It is very important that we look at
Mr. Harshvardhan,
what airlines are doing to the passengers.
A certain part of these notices
fact,
that have been issued to these private airlines,
I want to just finish,
the airlines have taken them into account because there was a deadline that was set. No, this is raising the same question with respect to what you've said, that DGCA should stop handling these airlines with kid gloves. There needs to be a zero tolerance, but there has been a progressive move in that direction. Some of those airlines have managed to replace those aircrafts, but not all. So is there a lack in check even in this later stage that the DGCA is keeping, despite issuing those notices, despite some of those aircraft's engines having been replaced? We are still looking at snags. Mr. Harshvardhan.
No, you see, look, any fleet would never be snag-free to start with. But to answer your question, the first thing is that the DGCA has been issuing these directives or advisories, essentially what EASA or FAA has been doing. You know, they only do the photocopy of the EASA and FAA circulars and pass it on to the airlines and then forget about it. The Indian DGCA, because we are facing the fleet problem, because, you know, Indian geographical condition, operational conditions are altogether different in many parts of the world, and every operator and every country finds unique experiences. So based on our experience, DGCA has to ground the fleet first, particularly the aircraft which are susceptible and fitted with this particular Pratt & Whitney engine. And till a satisfactory solution is found, you cannot allow the aircraft to fly. You know, I mean, it's not something which is negotiable, or whether it's the passenger comfort, whether it is fare going up, nothing can be considered at the cost of safety. So that is the prime duty, and DGCA is not there to look at the airline's viability or international relations. DGCA is here to look after the safety of aircraft and passengers and the environment. So I think DGCA has to realize that their role is
absolutely
not a PR role or a kind of a moderator's role. DGCA has a administratively firm role.
Is DGCA getting
and
its brief
until
wrong?
Until you have the competent DGCA, you cannot. Yeah.
Yes, please stay with us. We get that point. Going across to my colleague Tanima as well, who's also helping us understand the timeline to this as well, because this is something that we've been discussing for a long time on this channel. This is not the first time that a snag has been reported and action by the DGCA that has been sought. It has clearly been established what the problem is. Another extension of a deadline. Nothing changes on ground here. Tanima.
That's right. In fact, that is the problem which seems to be the case, Seher, that we have seen time and again that there have been instances which have been reported, not just this year, but since the past 3 years at least, several instances reported. But what has been the corrective action on ground? If you just take a look at why exactly has the inspection been ordered now. Now, this latest decision from the DGCA comes after, as we reported, this flight which was going from Kolkata to Guwahati actually faced a snag. Now, after that technical snag, if we look at the next point there, there was also, of course, this is not just the only incident. There was another incident with a Mumbai flight on Sunday. Now, on December 23rd, GoAir A320neo planes, PW engine, the Pratt & Whitney engine, faced a mid-air snag. So that was, of course, that incident which took place on Monday, following which the DGCA made that order asking for inspections or for GoAir Pratt & Whitney engines. Earlier, Pratt & Whitney engines of Indigo's A320neo aircraft had also faced similar issue. Remember, in October, a deadline of 15 days was given to Indigo, which was later pushed to January end deadline. But we'll still have to wait and see what exactly, how many engines that Indigo has actually checked and whether or not the problem has been resolved at that end. On October 28th, DGCA, as I was mentioning, had ordered Indigo to replace 16 Pratt & Whitney engines. But that, of course, as we said, it was a deadline which had been given at that point in October. That has now got pushed further to January end. So this controversy has, in fact, been on for quite some time. Indigo was, in fact, asked to replace engines which were used for more than 3,000 plus hours. Now, even in this case, Seher, if we see that the inspection which has been ordered by DGCA is of those engines which GoAir planes were using, which had in fact been used already for over 3,000 hours. So there seems to be that particular category which has clearly, you know, thrown up a lot of problems. So this is of course the reason why the inspection has been ordered now. But let us also look at some of the past instances which have taken place. There have been three instances in October and three instances in March, if we can bring that for our viewers. First, of course, are these incidents which took place just between a span of 3 days in October, Mumbai-Coimbatore flight, and then we have the next flight, which is from the Delhi-Goa flight, and the following that, the Kolkata-Chennai flight. In those 3 days, all these three flights reported glitches. If we also look at the data that we have from March this year, in which there were vibrations noticed by the air crew in the engines, the Amritsar-Guwahati flight. Then there was also a flight from Istanbul to Delhi, and then again another flight from Guwahati to Amritsar. All these flights, the engines reported vibrations, which is the reason why again an inspection has in fact been ordered. Now, the bottom line being, Seher, that every time there's a glitch reported, an inspection is being ordered. But what exactly is the result of these inspections? Have any of these airlines which are using Pratt & Whitney engines actually come out with a status report saying, okay, these are the inspections we've carried out, these have turned out to be faulty, we're not going to use these X number of engines anymore. What has been the result of these inspections? Because the deadlines keep getting pushed, there's really no change we see on ground.
Yes, the result of these inspections and also the result of the aviation ministry stepping in. Mr. Shivaraman, if you could add to that here, our aviation, because the DGCA is under the Government of India, under the Union Aviation Ministry here. The aviation ministry earlier this year, the start of the year, January 2019. So we are close to 1 year's completion of that incident, of the aviation ministry summoning the Pratt & Whitney engine makers for a review. We would have expected that we would not be having this conversation today, 12 months down the line.
Now, please listen to me. The DGCA does not have to seek any instructions from anybody. There is no point in ordering inspections of engines that have failed. Those engines have to be simply grounded and replaced by engines which have a proven safety record. Inspections can be carried out on the ground. But those engines should not be permitted to fly. The Ministry of Civil Aviation has no business to interfere with the DGCA's autonomy in these matters, because by law, he is bound to see that safety of passengers, aircraft, and the airline crew are ensured. There is no other go. The entire responsibility falls on the DGCA. Merely ordering inspections does not amount to anything. Those engines have to be grounded, and new engines or engines that have proved their safety must be installed. That is all. There is no other alternative to it.
But Mr. Shivaraman, in what you have explained here of the absolute autonomy of the DGCA, at the end of the day, it is still the Indian governmental regulatory body for civil aviation, and the DGCA comes under the aviation ministry. And if the DGCA is not being seen working with a priority on the safety of passengers, we would expect the aviation ministry to step in here on this.
Let me intervene. I was a DGC at a time when 400 lives had been lost. And an assurance was given in the parliament when I was appointed DGCA from the post of Additional Secretary Commerce that there shall be no interference with the DGCA in its autonomy. I was myself a qualified pilot at the time. And Mr. Arif Mohammed Khan, the present governor of Kerala, stuck to that position. He never interfered in my autonomy. Whatever orders that were passed by me and the current DGCA, he must learn the engineering problems of the airlines, the aircraft which are flying here. If he cannot learn, I think he better...
No, Mr. Shivaraman, we appreciate and respect your experience here. But today we are looking at the DGCA not acting as far as air passengers' concerns are concerned. As far as the safety of air passengers is concerned, what does one do next if the DGCA is not acting to its prime brief of safety of air passengers? Mr. Sudhakar Reddy, would you like to step in on that? This is not wanting this to be a debate as far as autonomy of the DGCA or to what extent it comes under the government and the aviation ministry. But if it is clear that the DGCA is extending deadlines upon deadlines and compromising on the safety of passengers, what is the next authority that should be stepping in? Of course, we would expect the government to step in here on this.
With all due respects to Mr. Sivaraman, who was an excellent DG with whom our association has worked, I must say over the years, the role of a DGCA has been completely diluted. It is nothing but an extended arm of the Civil Aviation Ministry. That is why about a week or 10 days ago, we have sent a letter to the Prime Minister's office seeking urgent intervention on various issues, including the passengers being held hostage inside an aircraft, inside an aero bridge, several times. You know, there are many instances in our country where such things are happening. You know, passengers are held inside an aircraft for 6 hours, 8 hours. And what is the reason? The reason is not told to the passengers. Sometimes it is the crew has, you know, crossed its FDTL, and hence the crew leaves and a new crew has to come.
And you're seeking
sometimes
the intervention.
Problem.
We get your point. So you're seeking the intervention now directly from the Prime Minister's office or the aviation industry. I'm afraid we'll have to leave it at that. We appreciate all the experts who've spoken to us, respecting their respective experiences in this domain, in this department. But at the end of the day here, today, if you have the DGCA, with a wider concern that they're not looking at the prime concern of the safety of air passengers. Remember, this is no longer just a question of an inconvenience or a minor inconvenience to air passengers. This is a concern to the lives of passengers. And yes, if the DGCA is not following that brief, we would expect then that the government of India, that the aviation ministry, to step in far harder here on this. Thank you for being with us.